Hello, 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 and welcome back to the Nexus Gaming Series. I am the Crushinator, and tonight I have an excellent Division C East, Division D East, Division E Heroic Division match for you. Bronze 6 taking on Big Push Power, Cardstock Support Group taking on Heavy Greg, Gen M Esports, and Unity. Here we go, go, go. There's the light bomb into the back. It's a stun onto four on that frontline sliding mosh. The tour bus catches them as well. Dragon Arrow is going to stun onto three. There's the follow-up from Ravar. Phoenix is going to get caught. Crown and... Whoa! ETC slides onto three and pops them all with the bump back. TomGen with the highlight play. Hello and welcome back to the Nexus Gaming Series. I am the Crushinator, and today we have a Division C East best of three for you. Kentucky Fried Falstad taking on Winter Is Coming in tonight's matchup, and they are all set and rocking. Let's see where we're going with the maps. Checking out the bands here. Battlefield of Eternity, Braxis Holdout, Alterac Pass, and Garden of Terror band away. Two very different band strategies on the maps from our two teams. We're going to start things off on Dragonshire, as chosen by Winter Is Coming. Let's go to the draft. All right, we're in it right away. The teams were great. They showed up. They hit the, you know, they hit the start button. It's everything you could want from a pair of teams. Kentucky Fried Falstad going to start things off with the Falstad ban. Seems a little antithetical, but sometimes you got to do what you got to do. Dragonshire, you're looking for bottom lane anchors. You're looking for, you know, good rotational tanks who can scout that mid, who can go and invade camps. Invading camps is my favorite part of Dragonshire because they never see it coming. How you doing, Voreal? How you doing, Hoku? Welcome to the cast. You see Junkrat banned away. Junkrat, one of those bottom lane anchors that tends to pop up on this map. Lunara, Hanzo, Zagara even can fill that role. Chromie as well. Dahaka going to be the ban here from Kentucky Fried Falstad, so really limiting global options. Makes me wonder if Brightwing is their intended first pick, but there's the ban from Winter Is Coming. That does leave up Johanna, notably. See if that's something they want to grab here or something they'll let pass. Looks like Hogger is what they value more highly. Anyone going to go ahead and grab that one? How you doing, Yanthor? Just heating up here. The Hogger first pick. Obviously one of our best top laners in the game. See if Winter Is Coming will snap up that Johanna or if they have other tank plans as well. Wild Pants opting for the Deckard, and it is going to be Last Malkier locking in that Johanna. So good area control between those two. Hogger does have a nice Unstoppable to get away from that business. So that is something that Kentucky Fried Falstad's going to have to be cognizant of. I wouldn't mind like an Anduin and Nubarak rotation here. You get another Unstoppable on the tank, you get a save in the back line, and you save your damage for later. See what they're thinking, though. Sylvanas Rhaegar. Okay, you've got the Rhaegar cleanse. Sylvanas can get a self-unstoppable later and has the Haunting Wave to get out of sticky situations. That definitely works. Nacho Luke, thank you very much for the follow. Glad you're enjoying the show. Winter Is Coming. Looking across here, they've already got a tank, so we might see a tank ban, and it is going to be Muradin removed. Johanna Deckard, they've already got the Hogger, and with the Haka band, I'm guessing Blaze would be the best ban for that position, unless there's another thing they've scouted here, which is very possible at this point in the season. Zul'jin will be removed by Kentucky Fried Falstad. Definitely a great sort of stand-and-deliver backliner with Johanna and Deckard controlling the space. Zeratul Rexxar here for Google Me and Pat Lesta. Follow me. Rexxar, not an often played offlaner anymore, but still, you know, a strong one on Dragonshire for being able to soak and hold the point at the same time. Gingerbread Man, thank you for the follow. Glad you're enjoying the show. Last two picks here for Kentucky Fried Falstad. They need a tank, they need a flex. What are we feeling? Thrall Varian. Okay, so going for some big time frontline control here. Solo Sylvanas in the back. Very forward composition from Kentucky Fried Falstad going into this Johanna Deckard. Could be a little bit tough to deal with. But they do have a couple of unstoppables to be able to push through the zoning of Deckard. Robot Wizard on the last pick going to give us a Kel'Thuzad here. Certainly a lot of frontline targets to be able to try and control. Well, Kel'Thuzad's definitely going to have to watch out for that spacing, because if Varian gets in range, the Thrall follow-up is there, the Rhaegar follow-up is there, that could be a sticky situation for the Lich Lord. All right. Very cool. Loading up into game number one here. Looking at the comps. Kentucky Fried Falstad feels like they're definitely just going to try to ball all in there. Well, they're into the Johanna Deckard, which is a very tough composition to just run forward at. Misha up front as well as a great, you know, zoning stun. So winter is coming. They've got the tools to deal with this. They've just got to make sure they're used effectively at the proper times to try to fend off Kentucky Fried Falstad here. We're loading in. Let's go to game one. Game number one coming at you. On the left in the blue, we have Kentucky Fried Falstad. Anyone on the Hogger? Magic Turtle playing Rhaegar. Krogdon on Varian. Shadow Droid playing Sylvanas and Conflicted on Thrall. On the right in the red, we have Winter is Coming. Robot Wizard on Kel'Thuzad. Google Me playing Zeratul. Last Malkier is on the Johanna. Pat Lesta on Rexxar. And Wild Pants is playing the Deckard.
Let the battle begin.
How you doing, Trupar? Hello, hello. Looks like Sylvanas squad heading to the bottom lane here. Google Me will see movement coming across, but Kentucky Fried Falstad gonna jump on it anyway. Deckard trying to catch one here. Shadow Droid gets out. Last Malkier gonna gather up three though. Kel'Thuzad hitting two with the stun. Can they get around Last Malkier? Looks like Rhaegar not gonna be so lucky. Nice trap and pickup there for Winter is Coming. They only lose a bit of their bottom tower. Hogger and Rexxar doing their thing. Is Kel'Thuzad looking for stacks here in the bottom lane? Currently five on that baseline quest. Varian looking for stacks on Q, up to five now. Thrall is actually taken down on the edge there. Zeratul visited and got that takedown. Camps are up on the bottom side, both teams getting those prepped and rolling. Shrine's getting ready to activate. We'll see what the shrine control is like. Last Malkier and Robot Wizard just coming right across, trying to steal this camp. Magic Turtle can't get back on the point in time, and the steal is complete. Just playing very confidently here. Rexxar going to hold the top side versus Hogger for the moment. Pat Lesta just trying to work through the very high personal regen of Hogger. Magic Turtle trying to get this point before getting back out there. Wolverine blinking away. Does manage to get out of there. Zeratul will be delayed there. Kentucky Fried Falstad controlling both points for now, but Rexxar's got the middle warded off for now. Looks like Winter is Coming. We'll get bottom side control. Thrall in the middle, in the area. Krogdon coming across, does not see Zeratul. There's the charge onto Rexxar. Taunt comes out, conflicted with the follow-up. Zeratul picking their moment closely. They're looking for Conflicted here. And that will be Thrall going down. Once again, Kentucky Fried Falstad controls both points. But no one able to cap the mid for the moment. Zeratul looking for a quick dragon, and there it is. Hogger was on the back camp there, allowing Rexxar to grab the top shrine, bottom shrine controlled, and Zeratul was in position. Winter is coming, gets the first objective. Inflicted blasted away there as the mid wall will be taken down. Dragonite gonna get a little bit more damage onto the fort, but should be going down here in just a moment. Zeratul not even worrying about backing up, has the movement abilities to escape trouble. Decent amount of damage with an early dragon. So right now Varian and Rhaegar trying to control the bottom side, losing that bottom wall, but no damage onto the fort. Overall, a decent enough defense there from Kentucky Fried Falstad, but they'd love to be able to find their sevens right now and get on even fighting tier once again. Looks like anyone's doing a great job of controlling this top lane. They got the Bruiser Camp during, and they're just doing some good work versus that wall. Kel'Thuzad and Deckard are on the way here for Winter is Coming. Will they get here in time? Camp is taken. Zeratul can't get on the point here, but there's the move onto Krogdon. Varian avoids the route, is going to get a quick taunt onto the front before moving away. Bruiser Camp holding court here, preventing any further ascent from Winter is Coming. Bottom side camps up once again here. Kentucky Fried Falstad wanting to get theirs locked in quickly. Johanna coming through is going to be a spot too late once again. Rexxar does not deal with camps very well, that's true. That's a great way to deal with Rexxar in that top lane, is to prioritize that top bruiser.
The shrines awaken once more. Who will wield the Dragon Knight's ancient strength?
Combo there out onto the tank. Varian has finished the level 1 quest. 18 stacks out of 30 so far for Kel'Thuzad. Taunt goes out. There's the root follow-up. Shield still available, though, for Johanna. Magic Turtle on the back line, putting some hurt onto Kel'Thuzad. The Winter is Coming is about to have their level 10s. That could be trouble here for Kentucky Fried Falstad. Hogger getting the top lane control for the moment as Johanna gets the bottom side. How you doing, Arcane 13? It was actually the team Kentucky Fried Falstad that banned Falstad in this one. It's the first ban of this set. Hogger just trying to create some space as Zeratul gets unknowingly spun through. Winter is Coming. Does have their level 10s here. They've got Blessed Shield, Void Prison, Unleash the Boars, Shadow Fissure, and the Stay a While and Listen. Kentucky Fried Falstad. Can they interrupt Google me? It doesn't look like they're going to be able to get there in time. Ooh, Hogger, no, gets the top side to stop the dragon. But the blue side, they've got Mind Control, Shockwave, Shield Wall for Varian. You see there, nice protect. Mind Control can land onto Johanna. Void Prison in the back is going to stop one. Root goes out onto Sylvanas here. Shadow Droid in some trouble. And there's a big combo onto Magic Turtle. They're going to get Thrall as well. Big time body blocks onto Rhaegar, and that is going to be a triple takedown here for the side of Winter is Coming. All the while, though, Hogger managed to control the top and pick up the dragon, so that will take some of the wind out of the sails here for Winter is Coming. Krogdon just trying to hang on down here. Thrall Sylvanas on the way back. Mind Control, ooh, just barely short there onto Last Malkier. Dragonite coming down. He's gonna send Johanna into the low side. Taking a bit of a hit there as Sundering comes out from Conflicted, catching Google Me. Zeratul barely gets away. Johanna kicked back once again. Bottom side siege continuing, still a bit of health left on this dragon. Stepping up there, just throwing some Qs at the structure. Zeratul on the backside looking for an engage opportunity, is going to be spotted there by Conflicted. Winter is coming, has their 13s. Another mind control there, not quite landing onto Robot Wizard. Last Malkier mounted, looking for Thrall. Movement speed from Conflicted is not enough there. Gonna be stunned, rooted, and fissured. Oh, Sleep lands onto three here. Can we get more from Winter is Coming? Baron trying to move away as Google Me focuses on the backline. There's a VP onto two, turning off the structure as well. There's a great route from Deckard. Shockwave comes out though. Zeratul caught in fort range is going to be taken down in the counter. Full combo onto Magic Turtle does manage to survive though. Augur in some trouble here. Anyone trying to move back but will be taking too much damage. Shadow Droid. Mind Control is only going to land onto Misha. That's going to be Krogdon going down next. Winter is coming. Showing some terrifying synergy here. In their ults and in their follow-up CC. No forts down as of yet, though. Kentucky Fried Falstad, they're about to be on even talent here, so not as far behind as it seems for the moment. We'll see if they can hang on here, as the next objective is getting ready to be called. Seize them and become the new Dragon Knight. Bottom side camp going to be picked up. We got a rotation here from Kentucky Fried Falstad. Pat Lesta, may have bit off more than they can chew here. Going to get rooted and removed. Heavy rotation there from Kentucky Fried Falstad. That is going to mean Winter is Coming opens up the bottom lane, though. Finishing this off here is Robot Wizard. Kentucky Fried Falstad, that gives them enough time to rotate down and defend this structure. Sixteen's on the horizon here. As Thrall is caught, Krogdon gets up for a taunt, Conflicted following up with a Spirit. Wild Pants has to use the ult. Magic Turtle catching up. Ooh, the mind control a little bit short there. Kentucky Fried Falstad went for that fight opportunity before 16s were in. Shockwave not going to connect there, but anyone dueling with the best of them. Benign Hogger on this top side. Looks like Google Me's coming through once again. Unstoppable is used, but Zeratul gives chase. Tries to get the regen with the trait. Not going to be enough. Just too much damage. Sylvanas is actually going down across the map as well. A split double takedown there for Winter is Coming. Rexxar is going to get topside control. Rest of the crew here from Winter is Coming, going to get bottom side. VP forced out from Zeratul. Combo just a little bit off there, but they still catch Varian in the root. Kel'Thuzad trying to make it happen here, but missing that ult means a big part of that combo damage is gone. Taunt coming out once again. Kel'Thuzad goes after the Rhaegar here, who manages to get the self-cast. Shadowfisher will not connect there onto Conflicted, but there's the combo onto Magic Turtle once again. This time, Rhaegar will not survive. Sylvanas going after Kel'Thuzad, but just a little bit off. Combo not going to connect that time. Goodness, excuse me. Ooh, Last Malkier going to be the one that's taken down that time. Robot Wizard being fed those potions. Should be enough to ensure an escape. But all the while, though, the Dragon Knight was picked up during all that scuffle. And is doing some work here in the top lane. Vaunus going right in there after Kel'Thuzad. Black Arrow's turning off the structure. Once again, just barely missing with that mind control. Oh, anyone taking a little bit of extra damage there, but he's going to be able to scoot on back to safety. Dragonite about to expire here. Shouldn't be able to take this down, and Keep will survive. Big flanks coming through. They're looking for Zeratul. There's the VP, but Krogon in the area. Zeratul, no way out. Good collapse from Kentucky Fried Falstaff. That does mean bottom fort goes down, so only Keep's remaining here for the blue team. Augur says no camp for you. Spinning right under the back line there. Gets put on a 10-second for that shockwave, and Augur is comboed down. Camp claimed. Kentucky Fried Falstaff trying to move away. Nice dodge on the Misha charge. Mind control there could land onto the bear, though. Uh-oh. That is it. The self-cast not going to come through that time for Rhaegar. Magic Turtle falls. ...17 here in levels. Winter is coming, trying to open up this bottom lane. Looking at Shadow Droid, there's that self-unstoppable on 16 coming in handy. Keep wall goes down. Conflicted looking for an opportunity, there's the charge. No taunt gun though onto last Malkier. Blessed Shield comes out. They're looking for the combo onto two. Nice route. Conflicted trying to move back in, but will be taken down. Augur spinning into the back. Anyone trying to make something happen here, but will be removed. Desperation plays from Kentucky Fried Falstaff, just not finding the picks that they need right now. Shadow Droid pressuring onto Pat Lesta. Keep is protected, though, at least for now. Next dragon is available to be taken. There's Magic Turtle going to get caught in the combo. Self-cast does land, but it's not going to be a 20 splash just yet. Rhaegar taken out. All the while, Zeratul just doing some sneaky camp business here on the top left. Robot Wizard doing the same thing here on the low side. Winter is coming, just trying to make an untenable situation here for Kentucky Fried Falstaff. It's just too much going on the map. Johanna headed up to try and secure a dragon. Should be a quick pickup here for Winter is coming on this one.
The fire comes for you.
Zeratul hops in and they're going to look for multiple keeps here. Top and bottom already damaged. Looks like the Dragonite's going to start on the low side. Krogdon trying to pre-clear just a little bit. Combo coming out. There's the Protect. Gets away most of the damage. Shadow Fisher, I think that was the level 20 upgrade that just spawned in the air there. His bottom keep is going to go down. They're looking for Magic Turtle once again. Shockwave not going to be the save that they need. Rhaegar and Augur go down. And this looks like it's going to be a march to the core here. For Winter is coming. Dragonite's still healthy. And core shielding is gone. Winter is coming. 19 takedowns to 4 in this one. And a dominant showing on Dragonshire. The battling continues. Thrall going to be taken out. The core goes down. GG. Certainly a one-sided affair there at game number one. Kentucky Fried Falstaff, they showed that they knew, you know, what opportunities they needed to try to pounce on. Got some good offlane picks for fighting on the correct talent tiers. But unfortunately, Winter is coming just too far ahead in that one. And the burst potential just a little bit too high. We'll see if they can bring it back in game number two. Check out the post game. Checking out the stats here. Krogdon on the Varian actually topping out the hero damage for Kentucky Fried Falstaff on only one death for the team there. 4 Winter is coming. Robot Wizard on the Kel'Thuzad. Top hero damage is 73,000 on 0 deaths. Wild Pants on the Deckard, also 0 deaths there for the red team. We'll take a look at the talent builds here as we update the scoreboard. And we'll get ready for game 2. Alrighty, game number 1 is in the books. We are going to go to a short break here, but when we return, game 2, Kentucky Fried Falstad versus Winter is Coming. Don't go far. Chase forward, and that will be the pick. Chaos Pigeon falls as well. Tammy holding onto the front line. Isolation goes out, does not hit. D-Shield and Ancestral used there. Juan Pablo, though, now without any cooldowns, has to back away. X-Strike from Genji. Will be stopped there from Uther. Johanna taken down in the mix. Flyest Draven receiving the short range. Ooh, Juan Pablo trying to trade out there. Will go down at the gate. Iron was like, I got you. And Genji's like, no, don't pull me. I've got one of my 17 mobility tools available. It's all good. Gotta watch out. The scatter arrow nearly connecting. Objective is claimed. Emerald Wind hits. There's a great follow-up stun onto the front line by Hogger, and Brightwing will be caught. Zero day attack. Trying to use that movement speed from the Adrenal Stim Pack to move out. Full Shield Immortal. Oh, great stun from EZK onto two. There's Treywork over the wall, and zero day attack will be going down. Nice chase through by Reset City, but now they've got to deal with a Full Shield Immortal in here in the bottom lane. Down to 50% and dropping. Synthesis now jumping in there, and this looks like Heavy Greg have the damage. Uh-oh, no control from Hogger, but Hogger will go down. Stunned by the core, there goes Diablo. Genji falls, core at 26%, and it looks like the defense will be enough. Sith trying to get away will go down. Malfiel falls as well. Core saved at 26. Rest of the team for Chongal Rescue Rangers is coming up. Tazek is looking for something. Anduin is put into the cocoon here. Stun onto the backline as Muidar tries to get a mosh but will not connect. Chaos Pigeon gets the stun with the fear follow-up. Hebrew Hammer, X strikes into the back. ETC going to be the first to go down in this scuffle. So many low trying to escape. There goes Anduin. Emski chases forward onto Zoom then Boom. He keeps getting slowed and cannot escape. Triple so far. Hebrew Hammer once more. Chaos Pigeon will go down. Pina Colada escapes. That's going to be a quad here for the members of Chongal Rescue Rangers. Nubrak going for the super flank here.
I'm coming for you.
Waiting for the team to come up. Is it coming as well? They're looking at patience here. Is it with the drag? Is the damage there though? It is. Malfurion goes down. Nice crab claw attack by Boogans Forever. Here comes Fade. They want to take a fight here. Slide from Cat and Wedge. Drinking Bird gets away, bumped back. Gust is committed, and there's the save from Goliath. This could be a turnaround opportunity for Duratan's couch. Wildcard still in the mix here. There's the light bomb to the back. It's a stun onto four on that frontline sliding mosh. The tour bus catches them as well. Duratan's couch looking to finish him here. That is a triple kill. They're looking for more. Yawners moves in. That is the swift strike onto Falstad. Quad kill for Duratan's couch. Can they catch up to Brett Michaels? Looks like the answer is no, but they've got a quad, and they're going to start marching through the top lane. Drinking Bird going way into the back line, finding Goliath there. Unrelenting Strikes goes out. Dragon Arrow hits as well. Taunt onto Malfurion on the front line. Goliath bumped away. It's a huge silence. Is it going to be enough? Hanzo will go down, and Goliath survives. I just Fizz coming on down to try to secure the kill onto the rest. Drinking Bird trying to trade out versus Yawners, but there's the blink. Kira goes down. The shorthanded defense double kill for Duratan's couch. TTO continuing to jump in. There's the stun though from the edge, and Muradin is taken out. It's going to be another bunker here from Blaze. Flyest Raven trying to get the resets on those Phantom Knives. Blaze will fall. That will be Maiev taken out as well. Somehow Quantum and Ferret going to keep on living here. Mike is caught and taken out. Iron being run down as well. And that will be a full team kill for Bronze 6 with the 3-level lead in the open bottom lane. It looks like they're just going to go try to take this game. May wants a flank opportunity. Corrosive slide goes out. There's the ice wall trapping one. Corrosive is just going to mosh on the spot. Catches four targets here. Still the only one unmoshed. Smackloud in trouble. There goes Brightwing. Misha is low. Welcome back. We are getting ready for game number two here in our Division C East best of three. Right now, Winter is coming up 1-0 over Kentucky Fried Falstad. And our second map is about ready to go. We'll give them the ready. We'll be on our way. Got a sleepy Jin in the co-catter seat. And Fluffy as usual. Alright, teams are ready. Let's see where we're going. It's going to be Tomb of the Spider Queen here for game number two. Once again, as chosen by Winter is Coming. We'll see if there's going to be any big changes in draft strategy here for Kentucky Fried Falstad. So we swap up the map. See if I can time out this draft. 4, 3, 2, 1. Boom! Oh, I nailed it. That's so hard to time out. But we did it. Tomb of the Spider Queen for map number two. I have a feeling Johan is not going to make it through the bans this time, but we shall see. You know what I want to see here on Tomb? I want to see some good old-fashioned Gul'dan. Give me the ghoulish Daniel. I need instant wave clear and big horrifies. That's what I need on this map. Kentucky Fried Falstad pondering their first ban, as per usual. Oku cheering for three games, as we're going to open things up with a Kel'Thuzad ban. Kentucky Fried Falstad not wanting to deal with that mess. Junkrat once again taken out here by Winter is Coming. Of course, safe wave clear is at a premium here on this map. Pretty key for defending. Chromie, Junkrat, Tassadar come to mind when it comes to safe wave clear. I feel like Tassadar doesn't get his due on this map. Being able to, like, especially if you go W build, you can basically clear the wave from the gate. It's pretty good. Maiev gonna be the ban here from Kentucky Fried Falstad. That's another one that, can come up here. Just having that extra wave clear on hand is quite useful. And Johanna will hit the ban board here from Winter is Coming. So, first pick options. You've got your, you know, you can take any healer you want. Gonna be Blaze here for anyone. So swapping up the offlane, no Hogger first. Wonder if we'll see a Vala in this one. Robot Wizard does go for that Falstad. Wild Pants going back to the Deckard here. So we do see the Falstad coming on in. Falstad is medium safe wave clear, I'll say. Can throw out the Hammerang from a decent enough distance, but I wouldn't say quite as safe as some other options. Frogdon taking the Anubarak Shadow Droid on Tychus, so definitely showing that their team is built to take out whatever tank comes at them. They've already got the Anubarak. I wouldn't mind a Muradin ban here, actually. Muradin's probably the most survivable tank left. I'd be banning that and forcing, you know, a squishier tank. Varian's pretty durable as well, especially into Tychus. I'm not sure which one I would want to ban more. With this setup, I feel like it's Muradin. If with a different healer, I feel like maybe you're more worried about Varian. But it will be a Hogger ban, so just trying to weaken the offlane options. There's still some very good ones left. Urel, Leoric. Even Dahaka does fine on this map. You're really just looking for a gem carrier that can survive a gank. Next two coming on through for Winter is coming. Do we see the Muradin? Garrosh Rexxar. Interesting. Garrosh pretty durable, but does struggle a little bit versus Tychus unless he can threaten a throw. Anubarak definitely going to have to watch the E cooldown while standing around Garrosh, though. Patlesta does bring back that Rexxar for the bottom lane. Kentucky Fried Falstad, last two picks here. Conflicted going back to the Sylvanas Magic Turtle doing the Anduin this time. I like the Anduin in response to the Garrosh. Hopefully empower Tychus and Sylvanas to step up a little bit more. Last pick coming in for Winter is coming. Needs some flex. Will it be the Zeratul once again? Yet he's living a best life. He sure is. He's big chilling over there. That Zul'jin does make it through. For Winter is coming. Once again, building a pretty good barrier around the Zul'jin to be able to play. We're kind of in a similar situation in this draft. Winter is coming, creating a no-go zone with their front line and Deckard. Kentucky Fried Falstad built to hit fast and hard, so we'll see if they can find the window to do so. Loading on in for this one. This is a tough one to call. Kentucky Fried Falstad, they kind of have to go all in. And I feel like their chances improved greatly once level 10 comes around. So they might just need to weather the storm, not show too much to Zul'jin until then. Wave clear as safely as possible, and then once you've got your light bomb, once you've got your Sylvanas silence, then you've got something going. But we shall see. A few more load bars, and then we'll get in there. We do have a Falstad in this one, just not on the team Kentucky Fried Falstad. Load bar's taking a little bit longer this time. Unfortunate. There they go. Oh. Alrighty. Teams are loading in. Let's get into game two. Game number two. On the left in the blue, once again, we have Kentucky Fried Falstad. Anyone on the Blaze, Magic Turtle playing Anduin, Shadow Droid on the Tychus, Conflicted playing Sylvanas, and Krogdon on Anubarak. On the right in the red, we have Winter is Coming. Google Me on Zul'jin, Robot Wizard playing the Falstad, Patlesta on Rexxar, Last Malkyr on Garrosh, and bringing up the rear is Wild Pants on the Deckard. Game number two is underway here. Falstad flying up to the gate. Looking for some Q stacks, none to be found. They shade to the bottom side, but it looks like it's the top side that the Sylvanas team opts for, but with Rexxar already in the area, they abandon their plans for tower domination. Decide they don't want to get caught this time. Big rotation here from Winter is coming. Garrosh not finding anyone with the Fishing Expedition Q. Throws a new brack over the top, but has the Burrow Charge cooldown. Being harassed a little bit on this rotation, Conflicted gonna have to go the long way. Blaze coming up to hopefully grab some of this XP. We gotta move here onto Last Malkyr. Throw from Garrosh, Deckard creating some space, and Garrosh will survive. This is basically what you want to be doing as Garrosh, is you just live in this area. You just stand there. You're like, you want to come this way? You're going through me, buddy. Anubarak staying mounted above here. A hero flees from battle. Oh, looks like there's a disconnect. We'll wait for a potential pause and let them come straight back in. Backside camp picked up here. Looks like our Zul'jin player is back, so no problem. Maybe kinda. We'll hopefully see if Google Me stabilizes here as the game goes on. Kentucky Fried Falstad was looking for Pat Lesta down in the bottom lane, and there is that pause. Alright. DC is now being dealt with. We'll get right back into the action once they are ready. I gotta remember that yoga mat tomorrow. There's a yoga involved work event. I gotta bring in the mat. Taking a look at the talents here, seeing if there's anything out of the ordinary. Looks like field study for Deckard. Is that the field study? Yeah. Each enemy hit by Scroll of Sealing grants 20% spell power for 16 seconds to 40%. A little extra healing there once you're hitting those scrolls. Looks like the R's are coming through. Let's get back into it. All right. Hopefully our player's doing all right as we get back into the action. Looks like Kentucky Fried Falstad going for some bottom lane pressure here. Anubarak keeping an eye on things. I don't know if that Deckard potion actually scouts. I think it does. Stun booms out onto Misha Bear. Misha's actually going to survive there as Falstad flying down to help defend versus this camp. Garrosh looking for a throw opportunity, but everyone mounted up will move away. Anyone, though, is thrown back into range. That magic turtle is there with a save, though. Just Anduin things. Zul'jin getting some abilities out, but no auto attacks. Garrosh was looking for Sylvanas, but didn't want to run into tower range for that throw. So far, Kentucky Fried Falstad doing a pretty good job of not just getting completely caught out by the Garrosh here. They're ahead on experience, no takedowns for either side. I'd say this is a pretty good early game for the blue team. I was saying that level 10 might be their big opportunity for these fights. We'll see if that ends up being true. Winter is coming, definitely controlling the pace so far. But no major advantage to be shown from it just yet. So that's where you can get baited out. Grogdon saw Falstad was in the area, did not go for the EN because they knew Garrosh was in the area. If you can fish with a Q and get a stun, that's great, but as soon as you commit the EN, you know Garrosh is beelining right towards you and you'll be a death hole. So I like that restraint from Krogdon there. He was working on that camp, now Robot Wizard gonna give it a try. Going for turn ends here is Kentucky Fried Falstad. They're six short right now. At least on 21. Anyone not going to let it happen? Ooh, looking for Last Malkyr there. Garrosh gets away. Sylvanas looking for a drop-off opportunity. Shadow Droid has five. That's not enough. It needs to be conflicted. Looks like it will be Blue Webweavers for our first turn in. Top lane focus for the time being. Falstad flying out in front of the gate there. Nice scout onto Garrosh. Defense is being set up. Last Malkier looking for a throw. Going to be bumped. Krogdon turns it around, though, and it's going to be Garrosh taken down. Nice response from Kentucky Fried Falstad, but Krogdon definitely was in trouble there. Luckily had the E available. A timely takedown while this push is going on. Robot Wizard and Google Me just trying to clear the wave behind this objective. Krogdon going in, gets a big stun chain onto two. Robot Wizard in trouble, has the long barrel. The dagger is going to be enough, though. Falstad will go down. Blaze dealing with the mid lane pressure while the rest of Kentucky Fried Falstad going after the top fort. Last Malkier has returned. With the Black Arrow shutting this off, Kentucky Fried Falstad going to pick up this fort. Ooh, Krogdon going in, new. That was risky, but I think the E cooldown was being tracked. Every time an Ibrahak E's forward, I'm like, oh no. Oh no. Atlest on 32 here. There it is. Krogdon thrown over the top with no E. Pops the quick 10, but taking too many shots, and Nubarak will go down. Rexxar gets out of there. Kentucky Fried Falstad being chased out. Last Malkier wants a throw, is going to find one, but Anduin with a nice pull right back. Shadow Droid getting behind the gate there. Ooh, Google Me. In a little bit of trouble. Winter is coming. Kentucky Fried Falstad has their 10s first. It's Bunker, Light Bomb, Cocoon, Odin, and the Mind Control. Winter is coming. Just got their 10s. They've got Decimate, Mighty Gust, Unleash the Boars, Stay a While and Listen, and Zul'jin still holding that 10. Looking for a Nubarak there. Just trading cues. Guillotine for Zul'jin. Force come out from Rexxar. Not going to be able to lock anyone down in Deckard range, though. Google Me playing a dangerous game with that Guillotine. See if it works out. Shadow Droid making sure that Garrosh doesn't just wander in and get a throw backwards. Cocoon goes out onto Zul'jin. Kentucky Fried Falstad looking for a way up here, but they're kind of pinned in the middle lane right now. Zul'jin will just break out and move back to safety. Objective cleared. All structures still standing on the blue side. Krogdon coming across here. Oh, is going to E in. Light Bomb is going to catch the Falstad. Nice route follow-up, and that is going to be Falstad taken away. Garrosh trying to decimate their way backwards, but they're turning. Ooh, Mind Control does not connect. Mimatine? Yes, I tried to say it a little bit more, diplomatically. But yes. Mid lane siege coming on through from Kentucky Fried Falstad. Odin and Black Arrows are committed here. See if it's going to be enough. This Krogdon's got to get out of trouble here. Pops the E. Midfort will survive for now. 13-12 here for Kentucky Fried Falstad. As winter is coming, looking for a favorable fight. So far, you know, they've got a couple of good throws. But they haven't been able to take that big, you know, team fight that they're looking for. To just trap everyone inside that Zul'jin range. Last Malkier watching the turn-ins. He's going to get one interrupt. There's Cocoon. That should give Shadow Droid enough time, and it does. Indomitable used. Krogdon going to go in there. Mind Control goes out onto Garrosh. Last Malkier gets a quick throw. Nice heal on the W. Garrosh escapes. Guillotine lands. Not enough for a takedown, though. Blue Webweaver's now on the way. Blaze pushing the bottom lane. The rest of Kentucky Fried Falstad pushing with the mid. Winter is coming. clearing the top side quickly first. Mid is basically already down, so not much to defend there. Falstad trying to deal with Blaze down here in the bottom lane. Blaze still looking okay on health. Uh-oh, they're looking for Robot Wizard here. Falstad gonna try to double back. Looks like they're just not gonna give chase. Falstad going on a journey to try and back here. Looks like we'll get away. Bottom fork goes down. Krogdon in the corner is going to put Garrosh into the cocoon. Mind control hits onto Misha. Can we get a follow-up stun? They do connect. Last Malkier goes down. Nice cocoon there by Anubarak. Your team connects. Does a damage. They get Falstad. There's the stun train coming on through. The light bomb is enough for the takedown. Wildpants in some trouble here. Winter is coming, getting way too bold. Face check in that bush. Now Zul'jin is going to get stopped at the gate. There's the root. Oh, mind control doesn't hit, but Krogdon's over the wall. Zul'jin is down. Took a couple extra cooldowns, but they do get it. Shadow Droid. Gonna get into the bunker. Uh-oh, Last Malkier is all of a sudden gonna take a lot of damage here. Now Garrosh is down. It's just a takedown train. Black Arrow shuts off the keep here. Now it's Rexxar in the cocoon. Falstad on the way out. Misha gonna go down. The Gust from Robot Wizard will save Pat Lasta. But just the wave of momentum from Kentucky Fried Falstad here. Root comes out from Anduin. Anyone tries to get the charge follow-up, but it does not connect. Guillotine does some damage once again. Kentucky Fried Falstad chewing on half a keep here. They still have all their structures, but they're still 20 gems away from their next turn-in. Being taken by Kentucky Fried Falstad. Marchy Me, thank you for the follow. Glad you're enjoying the show. Looking for their turn in here. Pat Lest has got enough. Red Web Weaver's on the way. Anyone going to be thrown in? Pops the bunker to survive there. Light Bomb coming out is not going to connect, but the follow up Q does. Google Me thrown back to safety. This is trouble. The Gust from Robot Wizard is going to reset the fight, and everyone will move to their respective sides. Top lane going to be cleared out by Odin. Winter is coming, going to work on the mid pressure with this wave. Garrosh looking for a throw opportunity, sees the crew coming across, wants to find Anduin. Mind Control is going to come out, and Garrosh is just being melted here. Big sleep, though, from Wildpants saves Last Malkier. Guillotine does connect this time and finally does more than one damage. That is Anubarak going down. Anyone slowed on the way out, Anduin gets the save. Winter is coming, finding their momentum here. Mid fort goes down. Can they get more? Anyone? Ooh, barely getting out of trouble there. Right now only 15 stacks on the baseline quest for Zul'jin. Not exactly where you're hoping to be, but still doing respectable damage so far this game. Kentucky Fried Falstad did a pretty good job of delaying here. Oh, anyone's going to just walk right in there. Going to go for a 4v5 defense. Falstad's actually back at the base. We're in 4v4 territory. Guillotine does not connect, and Zul'jin's going to go down. Kentucky Fried Falstad's taken over the point. Light Bomb hits onto three. Oh, no. Deckard is down. Garrosh will fall as well. Winter is coming. Gets their boss stolen and lose three here. A gutsy call from Kentucky Fried Falstad going in 4v4. They get that boss steal. They're currently 3 levels ahead, though soon to be 2. Ten seconds till Zul'jin is back, 15 on Deckard and Garrosh. In the cocoon here is Falstad. Do they have the follow-up CC? They're trying to time it out. The timing is true. Falstad gets taken down. Black arrows come out, and that will help secure this keep. Oh, poor Falstad getting ragdolled inside that boss tornado. And a full health boss is now moving in on the core. Can Winter is coming survive this onslaught? Core shielding is starting to fall. 20s are about to be here. They're going to try their best to defend. Proggon over the top. Garrosh is going to go down. Down to 75% and counting. This boss is looking a little too healthy here for Winter is coming to handle. Kentucky Fried Falstad comes back with a vengeance here in game number 2 and pick up the victory to even up the series. We're going to a game 3. Big turnaround in energy there in game number 2. Winter is coming. Just couldn't quite find the execution they needed. Great early game bullying there from the Garrosh. But Kentucky Fried Falstad kept their distance, waited for their advantages, and executed late. Very nice job from them. We'll see if they can keep it up in game 3, or if Winter is coming, we'll slam the door. Let's go to the post game. Checking out the stats here. 4 deathless over on the side of Kentucky Fried Falstad. Krogdon, the only one going down that game. Shadow Droid on the Tychus, top hero damage. Over on the side of Winter is coming. Google me on the Zul'jin. Getting close to that 50,000 hero damage mark. Pat Lesta, 0 deaths on that Rexxar. Take a look at the talents. Even up that score, and we'll get ready for game 3. All right. Series is tied 1-1. We are going to go to another short break, but when we return, the final game of the series here in Division C East. Don't go too far. The light bomb to the back. It's a stun onto 4 on that frontline sliding Mosh. The tour bus catches them as well. Durotan's couch looking to finish him here. That is a triple kill. They're looking for more. Yawners moves in. That is the swift strike onto Falstad. Quad kill for Durotan's couch. Can they catch up to Brett Michaels? Looks like the answer is no, but they've got a quad, and they're going to start marching through the top lane. Drinkingbird going way into the back line, finding Goliath there. Unrelenting Strikes goes out. Dragon Arrow hits as well. Taunt onto Malfurion on the front line. Goliath bumped away. It's a huge silence. Is it going to be enough? Hanzo will go down and Goliath survives. I just fizzed coming on down to try to secure the kill onto the rest. Drinking Bird trying to trade out versus Yawners, but there's the blink. Kira goes down. The shorthanded defense double kill for Durotan's couch. TTO continuing to jump in. There's the stun though from the edge, and Murden is taken out. It's going to be another bunker here from Blaze. Flyest Raven trying to get the resets on those Phantom Knives. Blaze will fall. That will be Maiev taken out as well. Somehow Quantum and Ferret going to keep on living here. Mike is caught and taken out. Iron being run down as well. And that will be a full team kill for Bronze 6 with the 3-level lead in the open bottom lane. It looks like they're just going to go try to take this game. He wants a flank opportunity. Corrosive slide goes out. There's the ice wall trapping one. Corrosive is just going to mosh on the spot. Catches 4 targets here. Still the only one unmoshed. Smackloud in trouble. There goes Brightwing. Misha is low. Will be going down next. There she goes. Izzyk stunning onto the back line. Here comes non-champion. Johanna just soaking up so much engage and damage here. Majesty wants to get these hits onto non-champion and Milikoffi. Kalaboth low, has to get away. Another Entomb goes out, this time onto Vala. Great positioning there from Majesty, getting the burst kill with that Mimic. Trey work, gathered up. Valkyrie coming on down. Nice silence onto Orphea. Is there enough damage to follow it up? Drag connects. There's the Ancestral. The Root does land, though. Orphea looking for any way out. Bit of self-healing, but it won't be enough. Xenochrist goes in there to try to help get the save, but will be just chain CC'd as well. Double kill for Reset City. Silence Entomb goes out onto Rhaegar. Rhaegar trying to turn around. Crushing Jaws catches two. Ancestral lands. Big splash. Gazlo's going to go down, and Saber Moon will survive. Nazeebo is put into the cocoon as the chase continues. Shoandol Rescue Rangers. That's another pickoff onto Malfurion. Muidar and Chaos Pigeon trying to run away. Last Iron Skin hits. Muidar is super low. Chase forward, and that will be the pick. Chaos Pigeon falls as well. Tammy holding onto the front line. Isolation goes out, does not hit. D-Shield and Ancestral used there. Juan Pablo, though, now without any cooldowns, has to back away. X-Strike from Genji. Will be stopped there from Uther. Johanna taken down in the mix. Flyest Draven receiving the short range. Ooh, Juan Pablo trying to trade out there. Will go down at the gate. Iron was like, I got you. And Genji's like, no, don't pull me. I've got one of my 17 mobility tools available. It's all good. Gotta watch out. The scatter arrow nearly connecting. Objective is claimed. Emerald Wind hits. There's a great follow-up stun onto the front line by Hogger, and Brightwing will be caught. 0 day attack. Trying to use that movement speed from the Adrenal Stim Pack to move out. Full Shield Immortal. Oh, great stun from EZK onto two. There's Treywork over the wall, and 0 day attack will be going down. Nice chase through by Reset City, but now they've got to deal with a Full Shield Immortal in here in the bottom lane. Down to 50% and dropping. Synthesis now jumping in there, and this looks like Heavy Greg have the damage. Uh-oh, no control from Hogger, but Hogger will go down. Stunned by the core, there goes Diablo. Genji falls, core at 26%, and it looks like the defense will be enough. Sith trying to get away will go down. Malfiel falls as well. Core saved at 26. Rest of the team for Cho'Gall Rescue Rangers is coming up. Tazek is looking for something. Welcome back. We are getting ready for game number three in this best of three. Kentucky Fried Falstad coming back there in game two, evening up the series 1-1 versus Winter is Coming. And it's all come down to the final map here. Let them know I'm ready to go, and let's see which map we're headed off to. It will be Towers of Doom, another choice here from Winter is Coming. See if they can turn the taps back on here for game three, or if Kentucky Fried Falstad keep this momentum. Draft should be coming up here in just a moment. Can we time it out this time? Oh, I was too early.
Of Doom.
Oh, it's that close. It's that close. That's all right. Towers of Doom, game number three. Got two games worth of draft information to ban off of. Kel'Thuzad probably remaining on the ban board here for Towers, but maybe Kentucky Fried Falstad will try to counter-draft it. They did show that they were trying to control globals there in game number one, and this is a map where globals can do some work. So they'll have to kind of pick their poison here in the draft phase. What have we got? Towers of Doom, if I'm going to blend my styles, I'm probably banning Dahaka Kel'Thuzad. Start things off with the Kel'Thuzad ban. Winter is Coming, I've been consistently removing the Junkrat. Let's see if that remains a priority for them. What shall it be? I might be interested in controlling a Nubarak, honestly. Junkrat is taken out. Maybe not a ban, but maybe an early pick here from Winter is Coming. I feel like that would be an interesting one. Ban the Johanna, take the Anubarak. Kentucky Fried Falstad mulling their ban once again. Once again, it's the Maiev that will not be allowed. Do you tempt them with the Johanna? Tempt them with the Johanna, then snap your globals. Could be a way to go. Nope, Johanna banned. Kentucky Fried Falstead. Okay, they're going to go back to the Blaze. Anyone feeling good there after game number two? Winter is coming. I'd like to see, you know, I think Dehaka and Uberak would be pretty cool. They're going to go Zeratul Anduin, so they're just going to put the cards on the table right away here. I'm assuming this is a plan where you put the Light Bomb on the Zeratul and you just blink onto the targets that you're looking for. Magic Turtle going to respond with Brightwing. Looking for that AoE cleanse opportunity. Krogdon snaps up that Anubarak. Winter is coming. They know that damage is what's needed. So far, Conflicted's played a lot of Sylvanas. They might want to remove that option just to put them on something else. Tychus going to be the ban here. Tychus ban. Could be a tip of the hat to a Diablo play. Could be the classic Void Prison Apocalypse. I'd probably ban Diablo. They're going to ban Dehaka here. All right, what do we got from Winter is Coming? There's the Diablo. Atlesta goes for Leoric here. So Robot Wizard on the last pick. Gonna need to be something bursty. With this setup, I mean, Jaina. If you're just going full Wombo combo time, it's Jaina. You do the ring, you do the VP, you do the apocalypse. It's a tale as old as time here. So what do you do to challenge that? Conflicted goes for Greymane. Shadow Droid goes for Orphea. They're going to have to watch their spacing. I feel like this is a Jaina here from Robot Wizard. They are up against a Brightwing. They've got the Blaze with the Bunker. Anubarak can just burrow out. Not of the Void Prison, but of, you know, any Leoric or Jaina business. Is it just Falstad? It's going to be Chromie. Okay. Chromie's good burst mage. Not 100% burst like Jaina. Has a little bit of extra range. Be nice to stay away from Orphea and Greymane with that extra range. So I think that's a good half measure there from Winter is Coming. You don't have to go full in on the combo. You take something that, you know, doesn't immediately die once a new Bracken place go in. I think that's a good pick. All right. Game number three is cooking here. Burst potential once again from Kentucky Fried Falstad with that Anubarak Blaze. Google Me played a really good Zeratul though in game number one, and I feel like the heroic combos are where they really shined. I feel like this Diablo Zeratul might be what they need to win this game. We'll see if they can do it. Teams are in. Let's go. Game number three on the left in the blue. The final time tonight is Kentucky Fried Falstad. Anyone on the Blaze, Krogdon playing Anubarak, Conflicted on Greymane, Magic Turtle on the Brightwing, and Shadow Droid on Orphea. On the right in the red, trying to stay alive here and take this series is Winter is Coming. Wild Pants on Anduin, Google Me playing Zeratul, Robot Wizard on the Chromie, Last Malkier playing Diablo, and Pat Lesta on Leoric.
Fight.
Game number three coming at you. Winner takes all here on Towers of Doom, as it was always meant to be. Ooh, Blaze connecting with the stun anyway, was looking for Google Me, but went right on through to Wild Pants. Waves shall be cleared, and rotations shall commence. Get the root there onto Shadow Droid. Nice polymorph there is going to deny some damage, but Zeratul goes into the back anyway. Brightwing gets the heal. And finally, they will find the way to move out. Shadow Droid trying to tag the Zeratul here. As the minions do battle on the bottom side. Comes out onto Anubarak. Krogdon could be in some trouble, gets pinned onto the wall. They turn around onto Google Me. It's Anubarak that's going to be the one going down, though. Nice pickup there from Winter is Coming. Oh, Blaze goes down in the offlane. That's a big pickup for Pat Lesta. Someone's going to have to... Yeah, now we got a camp invade. This is putting, you know... This is a big problem for Kentucky Fried Falstad, because now they can't catch the mid-soak either. Anubarak is rolling in here. Krogdon looking for a target. Pat Lesta, though, coming to join the fight while Blaze goes straight to the top lane. Shadow Droid trying to duel on the edge here. Camp stolen by Winter is Coming. By the way, glad to see all the new folks in the chat. Arcane 13th, Keen, Nacho Luke, Skinner Principal. Make the Nexus great again. What's up, Goon? What's up, Heretic? What's up, Thomas? Glad you're all here. Glad you're all participating. Kentucky Fried Falstad saying, hey, you know, we might go for a little camp steal of our own. Krogdon goes right into the fray. Wild Pants has to get off the point. Camp stolen. They're looking for Last Malkier here on the edge. Diablo taking some hits. Stunned at the gate. Wild Pants has the save just in time. Steal for steal here as our triple alter phase is activated. See if there's going to be any sneaky business here from Winter is Coming. Or if it'll just be an honorable trade on the top side. Sometimes you see your ambusher going up that way. We're looking for Last Malkier here. Has the shield. Looks like it will be enough, and it looks like it will be a simple trade on the top. And the fight continues down here on the bottom side. Who goes out? Google Me. Uh-oh, is caught there. Polymorph. Zeratul, I think, ran out of cooldowns. Magic Turtle trying to move here. Pat Lesta wants an interrupt. Will find it. Diablo going straight in there, but gets punished. They try to get the turnaround onto Conflicted. No catch there. Krogdon going after Chromie. Robot Wizard. Oh, gets the heal. Shadow Droid didn't get the Q to land, and Robot Wizard gets away. Wild Pants escapes as well. Does Chromie get the Sandblast? No. I was thinking this thing might do a little sneaky, but no such luck. How's it going, Saddlebear? You're just in time for game 3. Blaze getting the top lane camp pushing during all of this. Kentucky Fried Falstad even on levels and up one on shots here. Magic Turtle getting away there. It's camp invade time once again. Winter is Coming, barreling in there. They're looking for Shadow Droid. Here comes Brightwing into the mix. Krogdon on the back line. Anyone gets a massive stun. That is going to be Anduin going down. Zeratul has a blink to get back to safety. Last Malkier trying to reposition, but oh no, gets triple body blocked. The overpower, not going to be enough movement to get away. Diablo goes down. Kentucky Fried Falstad, they felt more ready for that one, and they retain their camp. Looking for Google Me. Oh, Zeratul gets taken out. The magic bullet of Greymane following post blink. Sappers marching on the bottom lane as we have a single altar phase coming up next. Just all camp steals all day here. Kentucky Fried Falstad gonna lock that one up. Last Malkier, ooh, can't get onto the point in time. Pat Lesta working the back line here though. A little bit split on the side of Kentucky Fried Falstad. Can they move in together? The Auric is going to be able to move away. Oh, anyone was getting greedy there, looking for Zeratul. Here comes Leo on the outside, gets the interrupt onto Magic Turtle. Atlesta, ooh, does not have an E. Cooldown not available. Leoric will fall. Oh, what good's a Leoric for? It's called trait value. Gotta get that trait value. Channel goes over to Kentucky Fried Falstad as they're getting pretty close to their tens. Level 10s are in for Kentucky Fried Falstad. They've got the Cocoon, they've got the Blink Heal, Cursed Bullet, Eternal Feast, and Bunker. Though I think the level 10 of Winter is Coming is going to be pretty dang strong. So the team fights, I feel like, are going to be leaning towards the red side after 10s are in, but we shall see. Cocoon went out onto Robot Wizard, but Chromie going to be just fine. Diablo full up on souls there. Zeratul hunting as 10s are ready. We've got the Time Loop, Light Bomb, Lightning Breath, and Tomb. Lightning Breath, interesting. And Void Prison. Very interesting. So going with a lot more single target than I was expecting. I was expecting the Slowing Sands. I was expecting the Apocalypse. Google me. Looking for a juicy one. Finds two in the back line. Winter is coming. Looking. Light Bomb comes out. I feel like I might have gone off too early there. Conflicted, though. Trying to get out. Diablo just roasting on through, but the Eternal Feast is just on top of Diablo right now. And everyone gets out. That was a mess of abilities. I could barely see what was going on. But everyone survives. Double Alter Phase coming through on the top lane as they try to chase down Diablo. Shadow Droid getting a weird movement there on the Q landing. Well, he's going for a sneaky top right, but Chromie says no to that. Looks like Greymane's got the top left channel. Stun on the top from anyone. Has to pop the bunker here. Robot Wizard is channeling. Winter is coming, is going to trade out, but can they get away? Last Malkier taking a lot of damage on the front. Eternal Feast comes through. Diablo's souls are reset. Blaze slowing everyone on the back line here as Pat Lester trying to create some space. Magic Turtle is stopped by the Time Trap, but has the Blink queued up to move to safety. 32-24 on the core health, still fairly even. We'll see who's going to be the first to break through and get one of these towers down. Bogdan trying to predict where Zeratul's going to be with that Q. Left side camp picked up by Kentucky Fried Falstad. Right side camp being claimed here by Winter is Coming. Bogdan and crew were thinking about it, but they think better of it. They're looking at Blaze here. Zeratul was in the area, but Blaze gets back to safety. Bogdan can't find Google Me there. Void Prison is available. Gotta watch that positioning. Taking a lot of attempts onto Zeratul here. Is Kentucky Fried Falstad. Has five in the bottom lane right now. Leoric in the top. If they're looking for a fight, they gotta find one here. Winter is coming, not showing an opportunity though. Blaze just going to catch some of this mid-XP. Double Alter Phase coming up next. Both teams have their 13s. All the ults are ready and available. Next big clash is now. Zeratul is going to show. Singularity Spike does not connect. Anyone trying to move away from Pat Lesta. Movement speed is causing Leoric to move into that back lane quickly. Light Bomb from Google Me, looking for Greymane. They do get the hit there. Zeratul put into the Cocoon and the Lightning Breath comes out. Bunker is used here by Blaze, but anyone is going to get popped out of there. VP onto two. Conflicted, though, is in the midst of everything, trying to trade out here, but Greymane is going to go down. Shadow Droid dueling here with that Q build. Pat Lesta in trouble. That's going to be Orphea, though, caught up in the mix. Winter is coming, gets the double takedown, and they're looking for more. Last Malkier with that regen. staying alive here while keeping everyone in range. That's a Nubarak that's going to fall. Can Blaze get out of there? Zeratul trying to get these last hits. Atlesta moves forward, but can't get the W. Still, both are claimed and triple takedown here. For winter is coming. Getting the better of that fight for sure. Can they turn that into a map advantage? They certainly turn it into an experience advantage. Nubarak is on the way. Blaze headed up to the top lane. Top left camp is ready. Top right camp is also available. Neo and Blaze not in the area here. Last Malkier is just watching as Robot Wizard whittles this down. Pretty even on experience. Even on core health. Uh-oh. Might not be even on tanks here as Krogdon caught moving forward. Gonna try to escape towards the top side. Last Malkier looking for vision. Krogdon, oh, nice job on the Q. That timing is difficult. Uh-oh. Three in the bottom lane. They're gonna get out as well. Good communication from Kentucky Fried Falstad. Robot Wizard wants a loop, is gonna find it onto Shadow Droid. Little bit of damage there. Orphea gets away. Conflicted is going to get hit there. Polymorph out onto Last Malkier. Nice stun train, and that's Diablo going down. Anduin was put into the cocoon there and could not get the save. Google me. Couldn't. Ooh, has to use the light bomb to try to back up. Krogdon having to peel away as the rest of the damage could not follow. Triple alter phase is activating.
Do not disappoint me.
Diablo is back here, though. Shadow Droid trying to finish this channel, but will be interrupted. Magic Turtle, ooh! Google me going in deep there, but does not have VP available. Looking for Brightwing. There's the Polymorph. Zeratul still working hard here. One for one on the top channels. As Pat Lesta has joined the battle, here comes Blaze. Blaze is stopped. Krogdon stunning onto two. Can Blaze follow up with the stun? No, that's going to be stopped by Leoric. Eternal Feast comes on out. Is going to zone out Wild Pants for a moment. Anyone in some big trouble here will be taken out. Trying to trade out here as a nice loop onto Conflicted. Oh, they're looking at Last Malkier here. It's going to be so close. Oh, Diablo survives. Greymane does not. Brightwing is going to be next to go down. Krogdon chased out here. Winter is coming, gets the 4-stack. They're going to get another channel here. And can they take out this bottom side? Zeratul trying to trade out with Shadow Droid right now. Dorfia still has the tower to retreat under. And it looks like this bottom tower will be going down. NGS is the Nexus Gaming Series, North American Amateur Competition. That's what we're playing right now. Bottom side wasn't really locked up here. Kentucky Fried Falstad coming through to defend, but the sappers will lock down this structure. Winter is coming with the level advantage, and now with the structure advantage. Be a moment before Kentucky Fried Falstad can step up here. Looks like Winter is coming, going to work on their back camp in the meantime. The orc coming around for a possible duel. Ooh, that always feels bad as Blaze when you just come up short.
Winters are rising here.
Winter is coming, trying to defend their structure. As a single alter phase getting ready to spawn on the low side. VP onto two here. Brightwing not inside. There's the light bomb. Cleanse comes out. Shadow Droid is going to get looped, though. Flipped right back into the pain. Orphea goes down. Alter getting ready to spawn here. Sappers looking to walk across as well. Still three sappers working here. Last Malkier gonna flip Progdon in. Time Trap lands onto three. Anubarak gonna dig back to safety. One sapper is super close. Looks like the sappers will be stopped, but still five shots into the core from the bottom side channel. We're looking for Google Me here. Time stop. Oh, nice overpower from Diablo. That's going to be Anubarak falling. Winter is coming. They've got the 20s. They've got the bottom lane control. And the double altar phase is coming up next. Kentucky Fried Falstad. They're not out of time yet, but they are in a difficult position. They've got to be worried about a double channel boss play. Sappers coming up in less than a minute here on the bottom lane. And they're not going to have 20s in time. Blaze just working here in the mid. Chromie coming around, looking for a loot possibility. Doesn't execute it. Anubarak's coming back. Double altar's coming up next. That's not ideal, but the time to fight is now for Kentucky Fried Falstad. Anyone scouting here? They're trying to take out the structure while they have a moment. It is close. The altar's getting ready to activate now. Zeratul avoids the first stun. Zeratul put into the cocoon here. First bullet goes out. Time stop onto Leoric. There's the lightning breath. Just trying to burn out the bunker. VP is used. Google Me connects onto two. Anyone in the back line? Little bit of shielding. Is it going to be enough? No. Blaze goes down. Winter is coming. Spooks on forward. That is going to be three down. They're looking for more. That is Greymane to fall. Shadow Droid, the only one getting out here. Winter is coming, looking like they've got the win. The sappers came across during all that. They're going to get the double channel. Diablo goes down, but it does not matter. Game over, set over. Winter is coming, takes the 2-1 victory. GG. Valiant effort there from Kentucky Fried Falstad. The late game team fights just not quite going their way. Nice job by Winter is Coming, putting together their combos. Wasn't the combo I expected, but still working out very well for them. They get the 2-1 victory. Let's go to the post game. Checking on the stats here. Shadow Droid on the Orphea. Top hero damage, 65,500 for the side of Kentucky Fried Falstad. Over on the side of Winter is Coming, Robot Wizard on the Chromie, nearly 65,000 on zero deaths, nonetheless. For Winter is Coming, nicely played. Put up the talents, put up the score. We'll see if we can find an interview with our winning squad. Keep an eye out, see if anyone's going to come on through.
Hey, hey, Crush.
Hey, hey, Google Me. Congrats on the 2-1 victory.
Thank you, thank you. They gave us a good fight.
Yeah, it was a solid performance there. It seemed like a very sort of momentum based series. You came out super strong in game one, and then it seemed like the opponent there kind of surprised you in game number two. What do you think happened with the tomb draft?
We were on the same kind of mindset of going aggressive, so we picked, you know, Falstad and Sol'jin, but then they kind of just played the macro game and played defensive and just out macros the whole game because we couldn't stack at all.
Yeah, so it seemed like
they beat us by strategy on that one.
Yeah, they were playing pretty well in the early games, getting around Garrosh there. And yeah, but game three, very close pretty much all the way through, but towards the end, coming out ahead in the team fights. Tell me a little bit about the team fight strategy there. You get through in a few different ults than I expected. I was expecting more of like a big AoE combo, but Joe had a couple different choices there with the time loop and the lightning breath. Did you change your team fight strategy at all going into 10, or was that the plan from the start?
That was the strategy from the start. We had to go void. We were going with the void combo, mm-hmm. kind of just get the light bomb and release void and lightning breath, hopefully in tune if he was there. Kind of enclose him in that spot. But that eternal feast kind of was going to counter us, but we managed to pull it out at the end of the game.
Okay. Yeah, the eternal feast definitely caught you on the first round, and I saw those adjustments being made in the later engages to avoid that just splashing forever. So those are some good adjustments there for sure.
Definitely. No. Yeah. It was a good team. Definitely gave us a run for our money.
Well, it was a very strong opponent. Just sort of looking at the division in general, it looks like there's a good cluster of teams near the top there, all doing very well. Team Cringe, you guys, Hotstads, Zul'jin Distillery, all at pretty similar records. Do you feel like going into the playoffs, this is sort of anyone's race, or is there, you know, sort of tiers of teams that you're seeing come out?
I think it's very close. It can be anybody, honestly. The top five teams are pretty good, the same level.
Well, that'll definitely be interesting to see there. Going into the later half of the season, we're, you know, only not too many games left, though there are quite a number of flex matches here in CE East. Are there any teams that you haven't played that yet that you're looking forward to facing?
I think we're missing. I think Deep Waters, I think one of them is called.
Mm-hmm.
We look forward to that match. They beat a team that I think gave us a good matchup last week. So, Deep Waters.
All right. We'll be looking forward to that one. Well, congrats on the 2-1 victory tonight. Very nicely done. The floor is yours. Any shout-outs you'd like to make before we close out?
Yeah, shout out to the team. Keep composure. We managed to win on third game. Shout out to Kentucky Fried Falstead. And last but not least, Crush, thanks for casting.
My pleasure. Google me, great job tonight. Good luck going forward in the season.
Appreciate it.
Bye now.
Have a good one. Bye.
Alrighty, folks, that is gonna do it for tonight's set. Thank you so much for coming on by. If you're over watching on Twitch, we got some good follows tonight. We got some good chat interaction. I appreciate you being here. If you haven't yet, make sure you hit the follow button to make sure you catch every cast that I do. I've got Wednesday, I've got a Friday, I've got a Saturday that coming up this week. Lots of live heroes for you right here. If you're watching live on YouTube, great to see you. Even if you're not, make sure you check out the channel, youtube.com/@crushcasts. You can see the live broadcast there. You also get the edited videos, you get the game of the week, and you get the series in 60 seconds, all of the content over there on the YouTube. So make sure you like and subscribe and do all the fun things. Let me know you're out there enjoying my stuff. I really do appreciate it. If you are over on the Twitch side, we're going to get a raid going to send you on over to your next streamer. So sit tight. I'll have you on your way. Thanks for being here. Catch you next time. Bye.